your glory isn't in it, huh? But you, got involved in such a messy situation, right? They're all wishy-gushy and lovey-dovey, right? And now the family is estranged all because you try to do the right thing.
When questioned further, the neighbor becomes defensive.
All right, that's it. I'm done with you guys. That's it.
And won't tell police where he was when Jimmy went missing. He refuses to take a routine polygraph test, which raises another red flag. Police set up surveillance on the neighbor and begin watching closely.
We know her since she was about 3 years old.
To know she is a lover. She loves her. They have a sexual relationship.
She couldn't do what they accused her of doing.
That is ridiculous! But the state of Georgia says justice was served.
Sheila Brown drove that car down the side of that embankment and set that car on fire with her mama inside the car.
No one knows for sure what happened next. But at his trial, prosecution claims that as Jim Bolton poured his wife tea, he took the opportunity once again to poison her with arsenic. Okay, well, there's a couple of things that worry me about that. And the first is that Bolton's a farmer, the practical man. He's trying to murder his wife, but he really keeps using quarter, and it clearly wasn't working.
We're transporting a 15-year-old gentleman to your facility with an obvious closed fracture of his right ankle. Is the pain okay right now? Hurting pretty bad. Okay. You ever had morphine before? It's gonna take the edge right off.
Don't you just count as illegal goods?
It's illegal if you take it all by yourself, but if I'm giving it to you for a fractured ankle, you're just fine, bro.
Sounds too good.
Well, that's good.
Detective.